Hi, it's Kim from Kim's Upholstery here. I'd like to tell you a little bit about this Sailrite Ultrafeed LS1 sewing machine that I recently acquired. When you receive your Ultrafeed machine, you'll notice that it comes with a nice heavy stand that the sewing machine fits right into. This makes it really stable when you're sewing on your table. This sewing machine can hold two different types of thread systems. You can use a regular spool like you would use for a home domestic sewing machine, which would sit right up on top of the post that's here on the machine. Or, in my case, I'm using a separate thread stand, and I'm going to run my thread off the stand up through the loop on the top and through the machine. So I'm using a 69 bonded nylon thread, which is a heavier weight thread that you would want to use when you're working on the heavier upholstery weight fabrics. Turn my wheel a little bit to get my fabric out from under the foot. And we can take a look at the stitching. Here you can see we've got a nice consistent stitch. This is set on the widest stitch at this point. And I want to show you how this reverse works. So I just, as I'm sewing along, I just pull down on the lever and it goes right into reverse. Show you that one more time. Now that we've sewn through two layers of fabric, I want to see how well this machine does going through thicker layers. So we're going to fold this and actually go through eight layers of fabric and see how well it does. So I've got my eight layers, put them underneath my presser foot. And this presser foot actually has a 3/8 inch rise to it, so you can get quite a few layers underneath there. Go in reverse as well. And you can see it, it's not even tugging on that fabric a bit. It's sewing along rather nicely. So let's pull that out from under there and take a look at those stitches. So going through eight layers of fabric, even turning a corner, it didn't bunch up the fabric at all, and my stitches are very consistent on the top and very consistent on the bottom. So that handled eight layers of a sombrella fabric really well. I'd like to try a few different weight fabrics for you on this machine just to see how they work. This next fabric I'm going to try is a corduroy that I use often in my upholstery. And let's go right to four layers and see how that does. So again, with our presser foot up, I get the fabric under there, lower down, hang on to my threads. And that fabric is moving through there nice and easy. It's not bunching or pulling. Very smooth and consistent on that fabric. So let's take this out of here and try some more. This next fabric here is a tapestry chenille. So it's got a whole bunch of different layers going on in the threading. So high spots and low spots. And again, let's go right to four layers. As if you're sewing a cushion, you'd be going through four layers of fabric with the two layers that create your cording and then the layer that would be the top and the boxing. And again, there's no resistance on that. It's not pulling the fabric at all. It's just sewing nice and smooth. If you've ever sewn with a chenille, oftentimes your chenille will bunch up. You don't have the right machine to sew it with. That one looks really good. My stitches are all nice and consistent. No puckering at all in that fabric. So let's try a vinyl next. Again, I'll go right through the four layers. And actually, let's test it a little bit by shifting these layers so it's shifting consistencies of thickness as it sews along. And let's see how that does. No problem so far. Try the reverse. And I can feel now that I'm going through less layers, and there was no hesitation with adjusting from up to down. So let's take that one out of there. And again, you can see all those stitches are staying nice and consistent as I turn. Now let's try leather. Let's go through four layers of leather. Oops, I lost my tail here. Let me just readjust that. Again, it's handling that really well. Now for all the sewing I've been doing, I am using a size 20 needle, which is a good size when you're working with these heavier fabrics. So far I'm really impressed with the way it handles all these different weights of fabrics. So now let's make a piece of cording. So I've got my FiberFlex 5/32 cording here, and I've got a piece of umbrella fabric that I've cut. And the foot that comes with this machine has an actual tunnel or groove right in it for the cording. So with the cording riding in the groove of that foot, let's check this out. Now it's feeding through there very smoothly. It's not taking much effort at all for me to keep that cording in the channel of the foot. Oops. Let's take a look at this. There, you can see that stitch stayed nice and consistent, right snug up against that cording. It's a really good end result. With this Sailrite Ultrafeed LS1 machine, we have sewn successfully through four layers of leather, four layers of a vinyl, four layers of a tapestry chenille, four layers of this corduroy upholstery fabric, and eight layers of this umbrella fabric without any variation in the stitching. It's been very consistent through all of these fabrics. If you're a home sewer or someone totally new to sewing and you're looking to get into working with some really heavier weight fabrics for upholstery projects or cushion projects that you might be doing, this Sailrite Ultrafeed LS1 is the perfect machine for you. When you get your machine in the mail and take it out of the box, you'll find that you have this really great instructional guidebook that has all the written instructions that you'll need for your machine. But one really wonderful thing that you'll get is you'll get Sailrite in the box with you. It comes with this 2-hour and 45-minute instructional disc where Eric and Matt will go through all the details that you need to run your Sailrite machine. You can take the disc, pop it into your laptop, set it up right next to you, hit play, and they'll tell you exactly what you need to do to get up and running for your sewing.